Welcome to Nationwide on the network service of the NTA. I'm Najaa Tutujani. On a sad note, the Duke of Edinburgh, Prince Philip, has died at Windsor Castle, aged 99. Joyce Ometu takes us through the life of the longest-serving consort in British history.
For 7 decades, he stood by Her Royal Majesty's side, always a step behind. Prince Philip was born into a Greek royal family and ended as Britain's longest-serving consort. Prince Philip headed hundreds of charities, founded programs that helped British school children participate in challenging outdoor adventures, and played a prominent part in raising his 4 children, including his eldest son, Prince Charles, the heir to the throne. Philip saw his sole role as providing support for his wife, who began her reign just as Britain retreated from empire and steered the monarchy through decades of declining social difference. Speaking outside 10 Downing Street, Prime Minister Boris Johnson noted the support Philip provided to the Queen, saying he helped to steer the royal family so that it remains an institution indisputably vital to the balance and happiness of the country's national life. The flag at Buckingham Palace was lowered to half-mast and a notice was posted on the gates following the announcement of the Duke's death. The Prince married Princess Elizabeth in 1947, 5 years before she became Queen. He had been by the Queen's side throughout her 69-year reign, the longest in British history. Joyce Ometu, NTA News.
Back home in Nigeria, the linkage of all railway tracks to seaports across the country is inching closer, with funds available to kickstart the construction of more standard and narrow gauges tracks. Minister of Transportation, the minister said this while addressing the media on the activities of the ministry and its agencies. Abdullahi Mohammed reports.
It's the Ministry of Transportation's annual ministerial press briefing, so a quorum of all chief executives of the agencies under the ministry was reached, with the man handling the management of national information attending. The eyes of the cameras on the Minister of Transportation, and with his shoulders high, he began with the railway sector, where the services rendered in the Kaduna Abuja, Lagos Ibadan, and Warri-Takwe standard gauge rail lines, he said, are saving costs and travel time.
To fly from either Benin or Warri will cost you 60,000 naira. Road transport will cost you about 20. But if you go by rail, 6,000 to get Abuja, 6,000. 2,500 from Warri to Itabe by rail, and then 3,500 by road transport, which is gotten at the rail station. The air-conditioned buses or air-conditioned taxis will take you to Abuja at 3,500. So if you put the 2,500 plus 2,500, 6,000, which is cheaper than any other means.
In the Nigeria Port Authority NPA, NIMASA, the Shippers Council, and several other agencies of the ministry are said to be success stories. And the Minister of Information says this solidifies the legacies of the Buhari-led administration. The annual ministerial press briefing has been a platform where the ministry opens its doors to the media and other stakeholders in order to exchange ideas. In Abuja, Abdullahi Mohammed, NTA News.
The Nigeria's Governors Forum has proposed to leverage scientific approach to turn around the country's agricultural practice in line with the federal government's efforts at boosting the nation's non-oil-based economy. The chairman of the forum and governor of Ekiti State, Dr. Kayode Fayemi, made this proposition while he led five other governors to Malam Alu Farms in Jigawa to see how the state is excelling in modern agricultural practice. Mohammed Musa Askira reports.
Landmass of over 23,000 square kilometers, Jigawa is endowed with over 450,000 hectares of Adama land, out of which only 30,000 hectares are being cultivated all year round. To activate the remaining cultivable land, Governor Muhammadu Badru Abubakar has been calling for the participation of the elites in the agricultural practice. That was the reason the governor took the five visiting governors to Malam Alu Farm, established by the state's APC leader Farouk Adamu Aliyu in Brinikutu local government area of Jigawa State.
The farm is really integrated, and we cannot thank him enough for his patriotism, for his support to the policy of President Muhammadu Buhari and that of Jigawa State government.
This is a demonstration effect of what our leader, Mr. President Muhammadu Buhari, has always consistently preached to all of us, that we must grow what we eat and we must eat what we grow.
By the clarion call from Mr. President that we should all go back to farm. Secondly, by another clarion call by the governor of Jigawa State, whom I thank God and thank him for at least putting me through fertilizer production in this country. What we have done here is to demonstrate that Nigeria can be a great country, that if we all put our hands together, we can make it happen.
Impressed with the farm facilities, the governors called for the replication of such modern farming practice in Nigeria to realize the federal government's dream for achieving national food security. The visiting governors also inspected 50.3-meter-long national flag, the longest in the country, hoisted at the farm. Mohammed Musa Askira, NTA News.
Meanwhile, the Joint Admissions and Matriculation Board, JAMB, says it has shifted the date for the commencement of the 2021 Unified Tertiary Matriculation Examination and that of direct entry, which were initially to start on the 8th of April 2021. In a statement by the head of Public Affairs and Protocol of the Board, Benjamin Fabian, the postponement to a later date is a result of unforeseen circumstances occasioned by the Board's determination to integrate the National Identity Number into the exercise. Dr. Fabian calls on candidates to be patient as the board is working towards resolving the issue in good time to enable candidates start the creation of their profiles. Similarly, 20 private universities cutting across the six geopolitical zones of Nigeria have been presented with operational licenses by the Minister of State for Education, Chukwuemeka Nwachukwu. This is sequel to the approval by the Federal Executive Council in February 2012 for their creation to boost the carrying capacity of Nigerian universities.
We look forward to working with the new universities and our older ones with a view to achieving a holistic and enviable university system.
The National Universities Commission urged the approved institutions not to derail from their mandate as quality assurance will not be compromised. Abdullahi Musa Suleja reports that with the 20 new universities, we now have 99 privately owned universities out of 193 in Nigeria.
For the growth of all universities.
For us to come today and obtain a license means we have followed some guideline and procedure and will continue to abide by the rule and regulation.
The ongoing recruitment of 1,000 secondary school teachers by the Akwa Ibom state government is receiving mixed reactions from educationists and residents in Uyo, the state capital. The respondents, who see the move as laudable to boost manpower in the education sector, however, maintain that it should not be subjected to any external influence. Clement Barikui reports.
The United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO, had recommended that for effective teaching and learning to take place, a ratio of one teacher to 21 pupils in a class should be observed in primary schools, while at the secondary level, 1 to 23 students minimum is ideal. In Akwa Ibom State, however, the ratio has gone up as high as 1 to 73 and 1 to 150 due to the introduction of free and compulsory education in public schools 12 years ago. This first batch of 1,000 teachers' recruitment into the state secondary school system is therefore to bridge the student-teachers' ratio.
Obviously, there's very urgent need for qualified manpower. And you need manpower to boost the manpower development of the state.
Recruitment are always done on need. Maybe that is when the need arise. It's a welcome development.
The processes for selecting the best hands are ongoing, and the state government says it is committed to taking only those who are qualified for the job.
Nobody will manipulate the score after you have left. So the system is very open, very transparent, as you can see.
Governor Domi Mane had earlier this year announced government's intention to shift attention to the education sector, and this recruitment is just one of such efforts. In Uyo, Clement Barikwi, NTA News.
The 14th National Council on Environment meeting has ended in Abuja with a call to improve on proper hygiene in a COVID-19 era. The Minister of Environment, Mohammed Mahmoud Abubakar, however, emphasized the need for more synergy between the federal and state governments to effectively address environmental challenges, including climate change and flooding.
There is urgent need to transform our food system, which has been the major factor in the issue of loss of biodiversity, fresh water, and deforestation, with its attendant effect on climate change. It is therefore expected that pertinent issues and climate smart agriculture and agroecological practices that will aid rejuvenation of soil and forest covers, among others, are discussed during this meeting.
The ongoing global COVID-19 pandemic demonstrates the interrelationship between the environment and human health, as well as the need to strengthen essential environmental health services, knowledge, and national capacities, all of which are fundamental to achieving universal health coverage.
The theme of the 14th National Council on Environment is Managing Emerging Environmental Challenges, Need for Strategic Approach to Sustainable Development in a COVID-19 Era and Beyond. The Federal Ministry of Agriculture says it is investigating cases of avian influenza, popularly known as bird flu, in the country. The H5 series of avian influenza was first reported on the 24th of March this year in Kano, Bauchi and Plateau states, and later spread to Gombe, Nasarawa, Kaduna and Niger. The Nigeria Center for Disease Control says 83 samples tested, out of which 7 were positive. A Health National Rapid Response Team from the NCDC and the Federal Ministry of Agriculture have been deployed to Bauchi, Kano and Plateau states for further investigations. NTA News is following the development and will keep you updated. It's now time to join Awal in our Lagos Network Center for updates on resident doctors on strike and other reports from that axis. Hello, Awal.
Hello, Najati. It's good to see you. A week into the strike embarked upon by the Association of Resident Doctors, Nigerians are still appealing to members and the federal government to reach a compromise to end the sufferings of patients. Hingino John Adams, who visited the Lagos University Teaching Hospital, gives us an update.
The strike is no doubt affecting patients negatively, but for 12-year-old Daniel Adebola, his visit to the Lagos University Teaching Hospital yielded positive results.
The doctor attends to us and they give us necessary things.
Some doctors, they are working, some they are not working. Please help us to pay their money so that they will be able to work, please.
The government should find a solution to the problem.
and see how they can, you know, come into agreement with these doctors.
Consultants and other staff are on ground attending to patients.
We've been working. Patients have been coming, GOPD, our staff, and we've had some sets of people that came for screening. We've been attending to all of them.
President of the Association of Resident Doctors, Luth Chapter, Dr. Hassan Oluafemi, revealed that though the industrial action is still on, resident doctors manning isolation centers have not withdrawn their services.
The Nigerian Association of Resident Doctors is still on strike. And as such, we can't, although discussion is still ongoing, but nothing has been achieved as we speak.
Nigerians are expecting to see favorable outcome of deliberations between the two parties in the coming days. In Lagos, Hinginodon Adams, NTA News.
Similarly, the nationwide strike embarked upon by the Judicial Staff Union of Nigeria, JUSUN, continues with no concrete resolution being reached. The gates of courts in the Lagos metropolis on the lock and key. Stern-looking unionists who manned the entrance stopped vehicles and persons from going through as the strike enters day four. The union says members will not budge until the demand for financial autonomy in the judiciary is met. While negotiations between government and the union is still ongoing, there are those who are being affected by the prolonged strike.
People who have been given granted bail, that they have not perfected their bail, they are languishing in bail, they are languishing in police in custody because of this matter. Those who have admiralty matters that require urgent attention. In that very matter, maybe you want to seize a ship, maybe a ship is betting and is about to navigate out of your territorial jurisdiction, you quickly want to arrest the ship. These things are not, there are no provision for that now.
Some will go for trial maybe this week, but then because of this fact, they cannot.
Nigerians are however optimistic that all the contending issues would be resolved by the weekend, hoping for suspension of the strike. Courtesy of new technologies, more Nigerians, especially youths, are now finding new economic haven in the fish processing industry. Adeni Itaewo reports that the new formula exciting both old and potential fish farmers in the country is a smoking kiln technology with its capacity for value addition and cost benefits.
Omuagbo Cecilia is 42 years old. She left a teaching job about 10 years ago to become a fish farmer. Now, she brims with confidence and pride, happy that her newly acquired skill and equipment, a gas and charcoal-powered smoking kiln, are making her job easier and processed fish more hygienic.
Smoking the fish, if you are dirty, will not make your market presentable. Packaging is very important in the farming. And this will really help me to make more profits. You know, when you go to the market, you smoke there, you pay some certain amounts.
Getting Yemisi Alabi to talk to me was a challenge. But it is not for lack of enthusiasm on our part.
My name is
Yemisi. Special needs notwithstanding, she is towing the same path as Cecilia, hoping to make it big as a fish processor and vendor.
They do some of this smoking in a dirty way. I do not like it. When I see the opportunity to be able to learn this, I know this is the right time for me to be able to do it cleanly, in a way that is hygienic.
Despite producing about 1 million metric tons of fish annually, Nigeria depends on importation to meet its domestic fish demand, posting less impressive figure in the fish value chain. That narrative is expected to change as more youth take advantage of new technologies which support value addition and better output for exports.
Those that produce maybe fish, for example, they made minimal profits. But if you could go ahead and smoke this fish, bring something out.
This smoking that we are promoting, it will enable the farmer to be able to add value to the fish, and it commands more value in terms of naira and kobo.
Encouraging this new wave of enthusiasm, experts say requires more capacity building training and other support. In Lagos, Adeniyi Taiwo, NTA News.
You're watching NTA Nationwide. It's time for a break. The news will be back shortly. Do stay.
My name is Boss Mustafa, the secretary to the government and the chairman of the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19. I've just had the rare privilege of taking my first dose of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, and I can tell you that we are doing very well in terms of our response and the administration of the vaccines all over the country. As strategic leaders, we are supposed to lead by example, and the president did precisely that on Saturday with the vice president, and we are continuing in that particular direction. The essence of taking these vaccines is to help us really fight this COVID-19 virus, and the combination of the non-pharmaceutical measures and the vaccine is the way to go in 2021 and thereafter.
Nigerian youths are about the greatest asset the country has at the moment. It is therefore not surprising that the administration of President Muhammadu Buhari is strategically responding to the yearnings of the youth through multiple projects and programs. Youth Entrepreneurship Support Years by Bank of Industry, the Youth Investment Fund by the CBN, and several other conditional cash transfer programs. Recruitment of 774,000 social workers, majority of whom are youths, and so many other projects that are beneficial to youths directly or indirectly. If the administration can do all this, definitely with a degree of patience and time, it can achieve more. Nigerian youths must come together to say no to terrorism, no to vandalism, and no to all disruptive tendencies. Hashtag Youth for Greater Nigeria, pacifying the youths, unifying the nation.
From dusk to dawn, 24 hours a day, NTA International is with you in your living room, office, everywhere and anywhere. We provide the company you desire in terms of balanced and up-to-date news, programs and the best of entertainment. Tune in to DSTV Channel 251, GoTV Channel 91, Freeview UK Channel 264, or you can download www.visiontv.co.uk. App for iOS or Android. You can also see us on Facebook and YouTube for quality content on the go. NTA International, Africa's window to the world.
With the top four back in sight, Liverpool welcome Aston Villa to Anfield in what could be a tricky tie for their Champions League ambition. Will it prove a costly visit for the hosts? Find out as Liverpool take on Aston Villa on the Premier League Live, showing on the network service of the NTA from 2:30 p.m. this Saturday. The Premier League Live is brought to you by Baba Ijebu in association with Goal.com.
Thanks for staying tuned to Nationwide. Buddies of 11 personnel of the Nigerian Army, comprising one officer and 10 soldiers initially declared missing, have been found in Benue State. A statement by the Director, Army Public Relations, Brigadier General Muhammad Yerima, indicates a joint search and rescue team of Operation Wellstroke found the missing troop dead in Konshisha local government area of Benue State. The Nigerian Army is appealing to the public to volunteer useful information which will support the ongoing efforts to arrest the perpetrators of the criminal act. A new Director General for the National Center for Women Development, NCWD, has been appointed. She is Dr. Asabi Vilita Bashir. The appointment announced by the Minister of Women Affairs, Pauline Tallon, says the new DG is to assume office on Monday, 12 April 2021. Dr. Asabi Vilita Bashir is from the Mankara community, Gwoza local government area of Borno State. She also lectured in the Department of Education in the University of Maiduguri between 1989 and 2003. Later, she obtained a PhD in educational philosophy shortly before she left the classroom for politics. The Nigerian Television Authority has opened the 2021 pre-qualification bid submitted by companies willing to undertake contracts for the upgrade of infrastructure in some of its stations across the country. Salwa Khalil Ibrahim witnessed the bid and now reports.
They were sealed, protected and delivered for the 2021 pre-qualification bid. The humidity did little to deter staff and management of the NTA from carrying out the process in a transparent manner.
We want in everything we do in NTA, let it be value for our money. We want to talk about efficiency. We want to talk about effectiveness. We want to talk about fairness. We want to talk about competitive bidding that will be fair to all.
The bidding is for 8 lots. They include construction of the NTA headquarters permanent site building, upgrade of production facilities at state capital stations, sustenance of dilapidated broadcasting equipment, upgrade of satellite system to MPEG-4, upgrade of production facilities to digital at zonal centers, Wonder Cube playout center upgrade, upgrade of production facilities at NTA headquarters Abuja, and reviving NTA Calabar Cross River State, which are all on NTA's 2021 budget and were all publicized on national dailies.
In terms of equipment, our signal will improve. If you look at our permanent site, you will see that the place is big and it has been abandoned for over 25 years. But from last year to this year, things have changed in that place, and God's willing, within this year, we'll see people operating from that building.
The process was adjudged transparent.
Staff members are highly committed. They have taken every pain necessary to ensure that transparency, you know, is brought to bear on this process.
100 bids were submitted by different companies and opened for pre-qualification before the financial selection round. In Abuja, Salwa Khalil Ibrahim, NTA News.
Thank you, Salwa. Nationwide continues in Maiduguri with Abubakar. Hello, Abubakar. It's over to you now.
Hello, Naja'atu. It's always good to see you. Muslims the world over are preparing to commence the month-long Ramadan fast, where faithful are expected to devote themselves fully to worship Allah and engage in good deeds that will earn tremendous rewards from the Almighty. Maimuna Garba completes the story.
Ramadan is the ninth and most precious month in Muslims' lunar calendar, the fourth pillar of Islam amongst the five. Therefore, it is obligatory for Muslims to fast during the holy month, as Ramadan fast is not just abstaining from drinking and eating, but also includes abstaining from immoral acts and anger.
Rasulullah showed us that anybody who fasts Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him all his sins.
Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, in one of his hadiths reported by Buhari, said, when the month of Ramadan starts, the gates of the heaven are opened while that of hell are closed, and the devils are chained. fasting is important for Muslims as it brings unity amongst faithful through performing of Taraweeh prayer after breaking of fast at mosques together, makes Muslims stronger against fighting sin and more charitable to others.
Government during Ramadan will distribute a huge amount of food items, especially those who are living in IDP camps.
Meanwhile, as Muslims prepare for the Ramadan fast, prices of essential food items have risen in markets to control the arbitrary increase of prices of commodities in markets. National Orientation Agency in Borno, as part of efforts to ensure citizenry remain, move to regulate the activities of such unpatriotic attitudes by some traders.
The leadership of all market units leaders, especially those in the side, in the grains, were also invited. We had with them. We've discussed thoroughly. They agreed that nobody will increase the price.
This effort by NOAA will greatly help the common man observe the Ramadan fast with ease. In Maiduguri, Maimuna Garba, NTA News.
And still on the forthcoming month of Ramadan, the changing season of Ramadan fast came at a time when the heat wave is at its peak, a period where frequent intake of fluid is needed by people to keep the body properly hydrated in this part of the country. Let's now join Yagum Subukar to tell us more on ways to surmount health challenges that may occur during this season in Borno State.
As Muslim Ummah counts down to commencement of this year's Ramadan fast in the face of high daytime temperatures, not less than 40 degrees Celsius in Maiduguri, the Borno State capital, what are the measures to be taken to maintain the religious obligation amidst the heat wave? With me to discuss more on this is a medical expert, Dr. Laraba Ahmed Bello. Ma, considering the intense heat being experienced at this time of the year, what are the likely health issues expected to be confronted with?
With this temperature, the body mechanism find it difficult to regulate. The younger ones, the obese, those with associated medical condition, those with psychiatric illness, they find it difficult to regulate. If one did not take care, it may lead to heat syncope, and then from there it will lead to heat stroke.
As a medical expert, what advice will you give to not only the fasting Muslims, but the entire people of the state on how to maintain a healthy living amidst the heat wave?
Taking plenty of fluid is very, very necessary. Once you start having symptoms, you should not waste time. You stay under a cool environment, even if you are nature or your work, need you to stay in the heat. You should develop a way of getting a shade and sit. People have a culture of putting ice block in their own cup or on their head. That one because it can easily affect the circulation of the brain. Dehydration is a serious condition that if nothing taken, it will lead to another problem. Whether you are feeling thirsty or not, you need to take plenty of water. More especially, the fasting Muslim, they should take plenty of water.
It is hoped that the rainy season sets in soon in order to ease the extreme temperatures being experienced now. It's back to you in the studios.
Thanks, Yagumsu. And that will be it from Maiduguri. Let us at this point return to Naja'atu in Abuja for more stories on Nationwide. Naja'atu.
Thank you, Abubakar. The Arewa Consultative Forum has set up a committee to facilitate the safe rescue of the remaining 34 kidnapped Afaka students who are still in captivity. It, however, says it does not support payment of ransom to bandits. This was made known at the end of the National Executive Council meeting of the forum in Kaduna. Achari Maxwell reports.
Had us clashes, insurgency, and banditry, including the recent kidnap of students of the College of Forestry and Agricultural Mechanization, AFAKA, in Kaduna, top discussions at the meeting, with the forum's chairman and former Minister of Agriculture, Audu Ogbe, presiding. Parents of the kidnapped AFAKA students who were still in captivity also came seeking for intervention towards the rescue of the remaining students. After submissions from various stakeholders, the forum calls for a holistic approach towards tackling the challenges, bedeviling the knot.
You go and hold a citizen and lock him up or carry him to a forest where he's helpless, and you put a price tag on his name that they must bring this money within a short time before his religion. It's not, we don't agree with such tactics. No religion, even in the whole of the North, whether Islam or Christianity or African religion, accepts this kind of thing. It's against the laws of God. So we are against it.
The forum reiterates its support for the unity and corporate existence of Nigeria in Kaduna. Achari Maxwell, NTA News.
Four bandit commanders and their lieutenants in Katsina State have repented and surrendered weapons, which include two general-purpose machine guns and 24 AK-47 rifles, among others, to the police. Dauda Mohammed reports that the bandits were received by the Katsina State Commissioner of Police, Sanusi Buba, in company of heads of other security agencies.
Other weapons surrendered by the bandits include two AK-49 assault rifles, 109 general-purpose machine gun ammunition, 94 7.62mm ammunition, and 45 rusted cows. Ado Salki, one of the bandit leaders who spoke on behalf of the others, described their decision to renounce banditry as unconditional and pledged to assist in bringing lasting peace to Katsina State.
I have surrendered my weapons. Now I am no more into banditry. I bought them to fight and protect my property. But now this banditry is not good.
Katsina State Commissioner of Police Sanusi Buba reiterated the resolve of the Nigerian Police Force and other security agencies to leave no stone unturned in dealing with any group or individual who refuses to embrace peace by surrendering.
The security agencies, in conjunction with the state government, will embark as soon as possible the process of reorientation and rehabilitation of these gentlemen that have surrendered.
The Commissioner of Police, while assuring that banditry and other crimes will soon be brought to the barest minimum, also enjoined members of the public to partner with the security agencies by providing useful information that will lead to the arrest of bandits and their collaborators. In Katsina, Dauda Mohammed, NTA News.
Ibadan Network Center is next, and Kemi is standing by for more reports from that zone. Good evening, Kemi.
Najatu, and a warm welcome to Ibadan. Plans to the regional transportation center by the Oyo State Makinde made this known while receiving the Air Officer Commanding Logistics, Ikeja, Air Vice Marshal Sunday Makinde in Ibadan. Ayomiku Ajibola tells us more.
Governor Seyi Makinde said his administration is trying to expand the runway so that bigger aircraft could land at the airport, which, according to him, would be a true alternative to Lagos.
They should be starting operation flight from Ibadan to Abuja, I believe, within the next 2 weeks or so. And then Ibadan to Kodakot should commence once we finalize the discussion that we're having with
the governor, who used the occasion to appreciate the Nigeria Air Force, especially NAV Detachment Ibadan, for its contribution to the security architecture in the state, said his administration will assist in upgrading the Air Force School at Iyanofa and help in connecting the school to the national grid. Air Vice Marshal Makinde assured the governor that NAV will continue to be committed to ensuring the security of lives and property in Oyo State.
You must justify the confidence that has been reposed in you by doing the job properly, that the NAV is ready to assist you in any way.
Air Vice Marshal Sunday Olaonipe Kumakinde was former College Secretary, National Defense College, before his recent appointment as the Air Officer Commander, Logistic Command, Ikeja. In Ibadan, Ayomiku Ajibola, NTA News.
And meanwhile, stakeholders in the agricultural sector in the southwest have urged government at all levels to support farmers in enhancing their capacity and assisting them to access agricultural intervention. This appeal was made at the Southwest Zonal Exploratory Dialogue on Food System held in Ibadan. Ayomiku Ajibola again has the details.
To achieve Sustainable Development Goal 2, Zero Hunger, which is central to the attainment of the other 16 goals by 2030. The United Nations have set the podium to address the challenges facing food systems and security among member states ahead of its food system summit in September, tagged Implementation of Exploratory Dialogue of the United Nations Food System Summit in the Southwest Geopolitical Zone. Stakeholders who spoke explained that the Zonal Exploratory Dialogue aim is to allow states to identify and explore different options towards solving the nation's food system.
I am confident that we can create a vibrant food and agri-business sector, which is essential in increasing food security, tackling poverty, and driving inclusive economic development.
This initiative is apt, especially when the country is gradually getting out of the shock of COVID. Southwest is known as the poultry place of Nigeria. In the next 5 years, if the poultry problem is not addressed, the poultry business is over.
The Zonal Exploratory Dialogue, which is expected to hold in 2 locations per zone in the 6 geopolitical zone of the country, has representatives from Osun, Ekiti, and Oyo states. In Ibadan, Ayemeku Ajibola, NTA News.
You're still watching Nationwide on the NTA. More reports with Susan in Makurdi after this timeout. Stay with us.
Contemporary times require practical skills to remain competitive and relevant in your organization. Therefore, take advantage of NTA TV College short proficiency courses to sharpen your professional skills. Basic Broadcast Accounting and Auditing, date 19th April to 30th April 2021, 2 weeks. Audio Engineering, Operations and Maintenance, date 19th April to 23rd April 2021, 1 week. Protocol, Event Management and Public Relations, date 3rd May to 14th May 2021, 2 weeks. Intermediate Camera Operation Techniques, date 17th May to 11th June 2021, 4 weeks. The course fee for the 4-week course is 100,000 naira per participant. The fee for the 2-week course is 80,000 naira, while the course fee for the 1-week course is 40,000 naira only. Accommodation inclusive. Venue for all the courses is the serene and secure environment of NTA TV College near Old Government House, Rayfield, Jos. For more inquiries, please call 0803-314-4383 or 0806-980-9807. NTA TV College, Jos. Training you to be the best you want to be.
Hello, I bring you wonderful news. The village headmaster is coming back to your screen. Mo wire abi mi o wire.
Teacher no more. I fell on 100. Teacher no more. I fell on 100.
The premiere of the new season of the village headmaster, initially scheduled for the second quarter of 2021, has now been postponed till further notice. We apologize for this short notice and promise to keep our viewers and advertisers informed as soon as we have a new date.
And I know that even you too, you are getting a lot of orders too.
We are trying, shall
we? NTA News 24. A 24-hour news station brings to you news and happenings 7 days a week.
News at 10 a.m., news update at 11 and 1 p.m.,
news desk at 3 p.m. and 6 p.m., and late evening news at 11 p.m.
Follow us on any of our platforms and keep abreast of events and current affairs within and outside our shores.
We are on DSTV Channel 419, GoTV Channel 46,
Star Times Channel 101 and Free TV Channel 703.
Journalists.
With the top four back in sight, Liverpool welcome Aston Villa to Anfield in what could be a tricky tie for their Champions League ambition. Will it prove a costly visit for the hosts? Find out as Liverpool take on Aston Villa on the Premier League Live, showing on the network service of the NTA from 2:30 p.m. this Saturday. The Premier League Live is brought to you by Baba Ijebu in association with Gold.com.
still watching NTA nationwide, and it's good to have you join us in Makurdi. Governor Samuel Otum has inaugurated the ultra-modern Totiv Palace and other road projects in Boko, the administrative headquarters of the Tiv Nation. The governor performed the ceremony alongside governors of Rivers, Sokoto, Enugu, and Nasarawa states. Charles Abba has details.
The Nigerian Air Force tarmac was busy with flights that convey the governors of Rivers and Sokoto states and other dignitaries to Benue to grace the event in Boko, the nerve center of the Tiv Nation. Governor Samuel Otum, who appreciated the contributions of the 14 local government areas of the Benue Northeast and Northwest in the construction of the ultra-modern Totiv Palace, harped on the role of traditional institutions in the maintenance of peace and order in various communities.
We have already commenced operation to get the 9 local governments from the Doma Nation to do same as what we are seeing here in Otupo for the Ochi in Doma.
The Totiv, Professor James Ayase, who described the edifice as a masterpiece, thanked Governor Otum for his high regards to traditional rulers. He took turn to confer chieftaincy titles on Governor Aminu Tambuwal of Sokoto State, Nyesong Wike of Rivers, Ifeanyi Ugwanyi of Enugu State, and Sule Abdullahi of Nasarawa, who was represented.
I am humbled and honored that by the grace of God, and I give glory to God, that this wonderful project is being commissioned during my tenure as Toti.
His Royal Majesty, the Ochidoma, Elias Ikoyo Bekpa, the Emir of Nasarawa, and the Gwamgwam Jos, lauded Governor Otum for the project and gave him their royal blessing. Governor Tambuwa responded on behalf of the honorees.
Continue with the work of reestablishing peace, peaceful coexistence, building bridges, respect for one another, and ensuring that Nigeria continues to work and work and work and work for the benefit of every Nigerian.
The governor successively inaugurated the 1.5-kilometer Apiraku Road, the 2.5-kilometer Shahu Road, and the Martins Dent Road, executed by Governor Samuel Otum in Boko Town. From Boko, Charles Abba, NTA News.
Following the lingering crisis between communities in Konshisha and Oji local government areas of Benue State, resulting in military operations in some communities, Governor Samuel Otum has called for restraints on all sides, including the military. The governor also directed leaders of the affected areas to ensure that they return the weapons the bandits took away from the military personnel without delay to bring peace between the warring communities. Again, Charles Abba has details.
The Benue State government has continued to employ various strategies to end the lingering land dispute between Bonta community of Konshisha and Okute community of Oji local government areas of the state. Governor Samuel Otum, who condemned the latest crisis, which resulted in missing of two of the security operatives deployed to the area to quell the problem, said a day was fixed for demarcation of the boundary before the skirmish.
The report reaching me is that the troops, while they were in Konshisha, they were attacked. But the security agencies were able to repel them. And in the course of doing that, two soldiers are missing. So as I talk to you, the operation is still going on. We hope that those bandits will be apprehended.
The governor therefore charged traditional rulers and chairmen of the two local government areas to, as a matter of urgency, work with security agencies to restore peace in the communities.
The state should also take this message very serious. The issue of security is not just for security agencies or government alone. It requires all stakeholders, and everybody is a stakeholder.
He advised Benue people to eschew attacking security personnel, as such would amount to warring against government and the society. In Makurdi, Charles Abba, NTA News.
The months of February to May are known to be the hottest period in some states of the country, with temperature ranging from between 30 to 44 degrees Celsius and even more. This increasing temperature experts attribute to consequences of global warming. Blessing Omeche Ebute tells us how Makurdi residents are coping with the hot weather condition.
The last few weeks have been characterized by extreme hot weather conditions across many states of the country. Makurdi, the Benue State capital, is known to be one of the hottest towns in the country. Little Salma and Hassana Sani, who hawk sachet water during this period, say they are making brisk business as people now consume more water.
That time when it never come, I didn't sell water. I know they sell water where. Now 1,000, when it come, 1,000 naira there, as they say.
Mrs. Victoria Essa, an environmentalist, says the intense heat is an effect of climate change and encourage people to plant trees as they emit oxygen into the atmosphere.
There's a microclimate condition under the tree because of the so much release of oxygen to the atmosphere.
Certain health conditions have also been associated with the hot weather, such as dehydration, meningitis, heat rashes, among others.
You notice that you're having headache, you notice that your neck is paining you, you're having stiff neck, you're not able to turn, you have malaise, you're weak, it's better to consult your doctor.
In the light of this prevailing weather condition, they advise people to drink a lot of water, stay under trees, particularly during the peak of the day, to avoid some of these health conditions. In Makurdi, Blessing Omeche Ebute, NTA News.
And that's the size of our package from Makurdi. It's back to Naja Atu in Abuja for more on NTA Nationwide.
Thank you very much, Susan. And from Makurdi, we'll be heading to Edo State, where the National Sports Festival is in full swing. And we'll be joining Mahmoud Ibn Muhammad, our correspondent, to give us updates on what's happening live. Good evening, Mahmoud. Can you hear me? Hello, Mahmoud.
Yeah, hello.
Now that the sports festival has continued,
hello.
Could you tell us what the situation is right now?
All right. Thank you. The championship is steadily progressing. Teams are also making progress as the competitions are getting tougher. Athletes are winning medals for their states. Right now, I'm at the Sam Ebumudia Stadium swimming pool site, where five finals of swimming events, are about to take place. While in the kickboxing full contact event, already over 15 medals have been won. Victor Aneken of Akwa Ibom State has won gold medal in the minus 54 category IKG, while Akintoye Abubakar of Edo State won gold for Edo State, and Daniel Emeka of Delta State also won gold medal. And at the main ball of the Sam Obemudia Stadium, heat for athletes have begun in earnest. Last year's defending champion in 100 meters, talking about Iho Sokiri of Delta State, has qualified for the main finals of the heat. And at the Uniben campus, other sporting events are ongoing. This morning, Team Edo defeated their Plateau State counterpart in the female handball competition, while Team Lagos also defeated Borno State in the male handball. In Langa, Delta State is pulling up surprises, by beating two of the top contenders in Langa. That's talking about Bauchi State and Zamfara State. So as it is now, several events are ongoing and athletes are winning medals for their state. The festival is going on normal. Everything is okay.
That's impressive. Those are some impressive results there, Mahmoud. But let's quickly talk about the welfare of the athletes, considering, there were fears about funding, but the federal government seems to have sorted that out. What more can you tell us about the whole situation, especially regarding funding, welfare?
Yeah, since yesterday's event where the Edo State government, you know, threatened to shut down the festival, you know, there has been a series of complaints, especially when it comes to feeding of athletes. Athletes are beginning to complain that the quality of the food, you know, given to them is below standard. I'm looking at the kind of activities they are into, sporting activities, which is so rigorous. So they need to eat good food that contains a lot of nutrients that will replenish their system so that they can be able to perform. So honestly, there are a series of complaints, and I don't know for now whether the state, Delta State government has taken note of that.
Thank you very much, Mahmoud. I'm sure the relevant authorities will do the needful. President Muhammadu Buhari has expressed sadness over the demise of a close associate and exceptional scholar and administrator, Dr. Mahmoud Tukur, describing him as a true patriot and nationalist. In a message to the family, friends and associates of the founding vice chancellor of the Bayero University, Kano, President Buhari says Dr. Mahmoud Tukur's service to the nation will be remembered by generations, underscoring his passion for a prosperous, economically strong and united Nigeria. The president recalls that as Minister of Trade, when he was military head of state, Dr. Tukur introduced a lot of schemes which revived the local industry, boosted exports, as well as regenerated the indigenous manufacturing sector of the economy. He prays Almighty Allah to accept him in Al-Jannat Firdaus. And that's our package on Nationwide. Thanks for watching, and remember to stand with NTA against rape and rapists. I'm Naja Atutijani.